Hello, good morning children. Today we are going to learn about the properties of rational number. And under properties of rational number, there are so many properties which you will find, like based on addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Okay. So today, in today's video, we are just going to learn how to add any two rational numbers and some properties related to addition of any rational number. So that is what we are going to discuss today. Okay, children. So now let's jump into the topic. Okay. Now let me give you one example. Okay. Now how would you add a rational number like this? Okay. How would you add a rational number like this? Okay. So this is an example of a rational number. So for this, what actually you have to do is you have to do the LCM of 6 and 5 first. Okay. You have to do the LCM of 6 and 5. Okay. So you have to always use your prime numbers. Okay. Always use prime numbers. Okay. So this is how we have done LCM now. Okay. So that means what do we get? We get our LCM as your 3 into 2 into 5. So it should be 5 2 is 10, 10 3 is 30. So our LCM is 30. Then once you do that, what actually you have to do is you have to make a long line and write 30 below. Okay. Then write 2, put multiply sign, and since middle has plus, so put plus, then write 7 over here and put multiplication. Okay. Now you're supposed to find 6, how much this is 30. So what you can do is you can hide 6 from the LCM. Okay. So from LCM's L, you can hide 6. 3 2 is 6. So what is left? 5 is left, so you can write 5. Okay. Now you are supposed to find for 5. 5, how much is 30. So you hide 5 and how much is left? 3 2 is 6 is left. So write 6 over here. Then after that you can follow the step. So 5 2 is 10 plus 7 6 is 42 divided by 30. So your answer comes how much? 52 by 30. Okay. Now you can bring it into its standard form. Okay. Or you can leave it as it is also. Okay. So your answer, that means when you add this to rational numbers, your answer should come 52 by 30. Okay, children. So just imagine. Okay. Now, if I deal with rational numbers which is having negative values. Okay. So just imagine if I have rational numbers with negative values. Okay. This is example number 2. Okay. Example number 2. Just imagine if you have like this minus 2. Okay. So in this case also same thing. First of all, you have to do the LCM of 5 and 2 using only rational number, prime number. Okay. Then you will get your LCM as how much? 10 over here. Okay. So make a long line, write 10 in the denominator and write minus 6 into leave space, write the sign which is between into and leave some space. 6 into and leave some space. And you are supposed to find for 5. So you have to use numbers only in the LCM's L. So you are using 5. So hide 5. So what is left? 2 is left. So write 2. So you are using 2. So hide 2. So what is left? 5 is left. So write 5. Okay. So how much should be the answer? It should be minus 12 minus 30 by 10. Okay. Now over here you have to solve this as integer. So minus minus you have to add it. So it should be 42 and 30 is bigger than 12. So you have to put minus sign divided by 10. Okay. Now you can bring this into its standard form or you can leave it as it is. Okay. Your answer will be correct. Okay, children. So this is how we have to add or subtract. Okay. So actually this property is addition and subtraction is kind of similar only. Okay, children. Addition and subtraction is kind of similar. So since I have used minus over here, it is not making any impact. Okay. You just have to solve it as integer format only. Okay. So and you just have to follow the thing. Okay. You just have to follow the step. Okay. Understanding, child? Very simple. Okay. Got it? So this is how we actually have some this is how we actually add the integers. Okay. Now children, I am going to discuss the topic under addition. okay, some properties which is under addition. Okay, so under addition there are some properties. Okay, so the first property which is under addition is actually your closure property. What it is? It is closure property. Okay, it is closure property. Okay, now what does closure property says? Okay, closure property says that if you have any two different rational numbers, okay, the sum of the two rational number is always rational number. That means if you have P by Q and if you're adding with another rational number which is RS, the rational number, the number which you will get is also rational number. Okay, that means when you add any two rational numbers, okay, the result is also a rational number. So this is the closure property. Then second property is your commutative property. Commutative property. Okay, now in this commutative property, what it is being said is, if you add rational number in this manner or in this manner, okay, the result will always be same. That means if you interchange their position and if you add the two different rational number and if you see on both the sides, the result will be same. So this is the commutative property. Then the third is your associative property. Associative property. Okay, associative property is also similar to commutative property only. Okay, not that much complex. Okay, but in here what actually is happening is, in associative property is we use three different rational numbers. Okay, just imagine if you are adding this two first and after that you add your x and y which is another rational number, and if you change the pattern, if you leave p by q separately over here and if you add r plus xy together first, okay, r by s plus x by y, if you add, what you will find is on both the sides the result will be always same, it will never be different. Okay, so this is what is actually associative property is. Okay, then after that we have another property which is your additive identity property. Okay, additive identity property. Okay, this is the third property, additive identity property. Additive identity property. So this is again very simple property again. Okay, if you add zero with any rational number, it will give you the same rational number. That means it will bring that the same identity of the rational number. That means, see over here also, in the right hand, in the left hand side also x and y was only there, and on the right hand side also it is x and y only. Okay, that means what did we understood? When you add zero with any number, it will result to that same number. So that means there is no identity change. Okay, then the fifth property is your additive inverse property. Yes, okay, additive inverse property. Okay, so in case of additive inverse property, what usually happens is we actually change the sign of any number. Okay, like for example, like just imagine if there is any rational number p by q and if you add it with minus p by q, the result will always be zero. Okay, that means what is the additive inverse of p by q? We can say the additive inverse of p by q is actually minus p by q. That means when you add a rational number with its additive inverse, okay, if you add any rational number with its additive inverse, it always results to zero. So that is additive inverse property. That means for any rational number, just imagine 2 by 3, its additive inverse will be minus 2 by 3. Okay, understanding chan? That means whenever you add, by chance if you are going to add this 2, okay, if you are going to add this 2, it will always be 0. Okay, children. Okay, so this is your additive inverse property. So this many properties are there under addition. Okay, so from here now, since our discussion about properties and everything is done, okay, so we can do some exercise. Okay, from our exercise, our 1.2. Okay, so from here your classwork will be to do question number 1, question number 2, okay, and your homework will be to do question number 3 and 4. Okay, children, 3 and 4 is your homework. Okay, there are so many other questions also that we will discuss tomorrow. Okay, children, that we are going to discuss tomorrow, and in tomorrow's class we will again discuss, and if there is some homework I will tell you tomorrow, and classwork also I will tell you tomorrow only. Okay, so this many classwork and this many homework you have to do, and you have to send me in my WhatsApp number as soon as possible. Okay, children, so please try to understand this all things properly and write it in your copy. And if you have any doubt regarding this video and this topic, you can ask me through WhatsApp. Okay, children, thank you so much.